Are you Muslims? Are you Christians?
I am Muslim, Hindu.
Okay.
Our friend there has no idea what religion he wants to choose.
Okay.
That's why he came here. He's seen your YouTube videos as well.
Don't believe
sister,
everything.
All these people around you, yeah, they're not your people. So why are you amongst them, yeah? Like a slave, like a modern day foolish slave. You're lost. You're completely lost. And then this dickhead here trying to argue with me. Like what? Who are you? Who are you? The Archbishop? Are you? Who are you? The Pope? Who are you?
Sir, what is your
You're
problem?
Just a stupid fool, bro.
Sir, are you
about
Muslim?
To argue with me.
Sir, are you Muslim?
Go research about me. Go find out about me before you start chatting shit. Prick.
Sir, just be careful. You are very much loved by our crucified and risen Lord, okay? Don't deal with those things.
No. I mean, everyone is very important in the presence of God.
Yep.
Nobody is useless. But is man making people useless? But God made us equal.
I respect everything she said. I respect all of you.
Give her a hug.
Yeah, exactly. As a Muslim myself, I don't think he's Muslim. If he's arguing like that.
Why are you Muslim?
Why am I Muslim?
You asked me the same question.
Yes, and you didn't want to talk about it.
Okay. He's a Muslim.
Why are you Muslim?
I'm Muslim because I just follow. Well, my parents were, and they gave me a choice, and I just like, okay, yeah, I believe in like the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the final messenger, and that there's no god but Allah. That's the reason why I'm Muslim.
Yeah. So, in that case, do you believe that Muhammad is the best example to humanity, as the Quran states, and do you believe in oneness of Allah?
Then are you going to bring up the point of Aisha radiallahu anha?
I don't know, depend on what we are going to discuss, so I can bring up lots
I mean,
of points.
I want to say that I'm not like really knowledgeable, that's why I came here to learn, so I'm not really here to debate. But that if that I'd say yes, but then I know what you're going to lead on to, and you're going to say, is
but,
this okay?
But so you heard about the story of Aisha then?
I've heard about it, okay. And I've heard different interpretations as well.
What is your own interpretation or your own take into that?
I'm still reading on it. I couldn't give you a definite answer because it changes every day.
But would you have a problem for, I don't know, someone in his 50s to have sex with a child?
It's like, she's like, do you know like Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam got with Aisha radiallahu
anha? Yeah,
yeah, yeah. That's the point.
I understand that you're the mother of all beings, yeah? You, black woman, is the mother of all. But your children now are racist. They hate you.
They don't hate me.
Yes, they hate you,
sir,
because I'm your son.
Sir.
And they hate me.
She is Christian. There is no color code in Christ. Watch out what you are saying, okay?
Shut the fuck up, you
be
idiot.
Be careful
you
what
idiot.
You say.
Woman.
I'm not
How
Muhammad.
Many racist people are Christians?
Sir,
are you dumb?
Sir.
Sir. Bitch.
Sir.
You
there
idiot.
Is no color code.
How many racist people are Christian?
There
you fool.
No don't spit on
dummy.
Me.
Dummy.
Don't spit on me.
How many racist people are Christian?
With
none.
Are you fasting today?
Shut your mouth about my fasting.
Are you fasting today? Say. Watch out your language, sir.
You actually told me that no Christians are
sir,
racist. Are you dumb?
Sir,
Dumbo.
Sir.
Dumbo. You idiot. Yeah. Listen. You just said the most stupidest thing ever. You tried to say that no Christian is racist.
Sir,
are you
I
dumb?
Said there is no color code in Christ. There is no color code in Christ.
That's not true.
No.
There is no gender in Christ.
I came to the Lordship of Israel. I came to the Lordship of Israel.
But something in the mindset.
You people been everywhere with a gun.
I don't even have a gun, sir. Sir, I don't have a gun. I don't have a gun. Don't put my life in danger with your false claims. I don't have a gun. Don't put my life in danger with your stupid false claims. Sister, you are very much loved. Don't believe in that junk. Where is the man? Sir.
Pardon?
Anyways.
So, do you have a problem with that? Because I'm not going to use the example of Aisha. I'm going to ask something else. Is that okay?
I mean,
like you thought, did you thought about it? Have you reflect on it?
I mean, I haven't properly thought about it. I've just seen like people like you just like argue about it, and I'm just like, okay, what happens? It's like,
so people are having debates or discussions or arguing.
Yeah.
Have you kind of?
I haven't formed an opinion on it. No, not yet.
Okay, but you have a problem if man in his 50s having sex with a child who is not bleeding yet.
Well, in this time, I'd say yes.
Okay. Are you Sunni Muslim?
Alhamdulillah, yes.
So there is a Quranic...
Who are the children? Who are the children?
Oh! Chabita!
So there is verse in the Quran, Surah 65 verse 4. Did you come across with that?
Pardon?
Surah 65 verse 4.
I mean, you're acting like I know the whole Quran by heart. I do not. I may have read it.
Yeah.
Shall we read it? If you want to, go for it.
And those who no longer accept menstruation among your women, if you doubt, then their period is 3 months. And for those who have not menstruated, and for those who are pregnant, their term is until they give birth. And whoever fears Allah, He will make for him of his matter easy.
Can I say something? Is that in English?
That's English.
Okay, so in Arabic, you can't literally translate everything because it just doesn't work like that.
So when this Muslim translated this Quran,
they put their own interpretations into it. Have you seen like the brackets and stuff?
So can
that
you?
Is like, I can't translate it. I don't know Arabic, but I can tell you now.
So what is the problem so far? What I read?
I mean, I need to see the whole context. I need to see like the whole thing in Arabic. I can't read Arabic, so I'm.
Why
just
do you want to see it then? If no, you can't
I'm
even
just
read
saying
Arabic.
Like if I'm knowledgeable in Arabic, I'd look at the context, look at any metaphors, because in Arabic speakers love their metaphors. Because, like, let me give you an example. Yadallah. Yadallah means hand of Allah, literally. And if I'm saying God has a hand, that I'm done sin then, that should. Because I'm saying that God literally has a hand, a human attribute that God, who is above all of us, has. But
Allah, that, Allah does have a hand, this, and no, His hand is cold.
No, by Yadallah, they mean the hand of Allah.
It doesn't like us.
It's like
it's
He's
different.
Like just
I'll,
above
I'll
us.
Come
it's
to
like
that one. Just give me a second.
Controlling everything. So yeah. Like, He is God. That's why He has a Yadallah. So He has a hand. He has a hand which controls everything. So I don't mean it literally.
So let me respond. Let me respond. First of all, in Surah 65, verse 4, it would be helpful if you just give me what is your understanding so far from the translation that you think actually Arabic is important at that stage for you to check it out. That's the first point. Second point regarding the hand of Allah. There are sources explains hand of Allah is touching the back of Muhammad and it's cold. So it is talking about physical hand of Allah. I am sorry, you
that
have a problem. What is the metaphorical
okay,
for that? Let me open
example,
that.
Oh, I've touched you with my words. Have I literally touched you with my words? Exactly. So that's the metaphor. So tell me what it means when
Allah touched the back.
Well, actually, like I'm all knowledgeable and everything. Like I'm a harpist. I'm a sheikh. No.
Allah says, Yadullah. We don't take the literal meaning.
Yeah. Give me the meaning of this. Give me the meaning of this. So I am waiting I am waiting for the meaning of Surah 65 verse 4 and then hands of Allah.
Listen, we don't make tashbih. Yeah, we don't make it to the creation. The creator is not like the creation. You understand? Okay? So we won't make the ta'wil interpretation. See, you're not on the level to discuss. If you want to pull out the Arabic books, let's discuss. So how can you discuss? You're discussing in English.
So your God doesn't even understand the Arabic. When Muslims translated the sources to English, are you telling me they were all just wasting their time? And they were all deceiving people, while 85%, minimum of 85% of Muslim world doesn't understand Arabic. That gentleman is Muslim, he doesn't understand Arabic, and sources are being translated mainly for Muslims, and you are just saying everyone was rubbish because we need Arabic. Poor Allah couldn't even speak the English language. So let me come to the who is listening to hand of Allah. Sir, are you listening? Yeah. Let me give you the details and then you explain it to me. Yeah. So I have one of my hand has 5 fingers. How many fingers does Allah have? So no, let me read it to you and then you tell it to me.
Allah doesn't create it.
Allah's hands.
He doesn't create it as a human. He don't have a hand. It meaning the power. The hand is meaning the power.
So Allah failed to say power. Now Allah is having communication issues.
The hand of Allah in the ayah is meaning the power of Allah. He is not create himself. He is not describe himself as a human. Okay? He describe himself as he's a nur. You know, he's not a human. Have hand or legs or whatever. He's a nur.
Okay, what's your name?
Wahid.
Wahid. So let me read a couple of things and then you explain that to me.
No, not from my...
Okay, that's fine. I'm going to read the Islamic sources and then you explain that to me, okay? First of all, let me deal with the first point that Allah... Where is it? Let's deal with what Allah looks like. Listen very carefully. The Prophet said, sir, don't cry. I am answering gentleman's question. Can you have respect to him?
Listen, Allah's got more than 99 attributes, but he revealed in the Quran, and Muhammad SAW told us 99 attributes. Okay? Yadullah, Wajh, Shin, all this is in the Quran. We take it, we affirm it, but we don't interpret it like human. Not like my hand, not like my shin, not like my arm. The way Allah is whatever fits his majesty. Okay? Right? We don't.
That doesn't make sense to me. That doesn't make sense to me. Islam is supposed to be religion for everyone, but very basic of Allah doesn't make sense to me.
Do you understand Tawheed?
So very basic of Allah doesn't make sense. So let me just read what Muhammad said. Muhammad said, I saw my Lord with curly hair, a young man with mustache, but no beard, wearing green clothes. Muhammad said, listen. I saw my Lord with curly hair, a young man with mustache but no beard, wearing green clothes.
Okay. Harry Potter, he brought it.
That's Harry Potter. Islamic sources are Harry Potter now. Let me continue. Allah and his hands.
Allah has curly hair like Michael Jackson.
Don't insult Michael Jackson. According to Islamic sources, Allah is young. Michael Jackson doesn't wear green. Allah wears green. Don't insult Michael Jackson.
My Allah is different than your Allah. Maybe your Allah is...
Don't touch me. So now let's deal with Allah and his hands. Allah... Muhammad says, this is not me, Muhammad is saying, I know Allah is laughable. He's got curly hair, he probably doesn't even brush it. Muhammad said, Allah's hand is full. His throne is on the water and in his other hand is the balance.
I never heard this in Quran. I don't know from where you brought this. Sorry.
And another one. And Muhammad said, and both, peace be upon him, and both of his hands are right hands. Can you imagine? Allah can't even balance because he doesn't have left hand.
Nobody heard this, what story was talking.
Oh, Sunnah al-Nasa.
Go to Chinese Google.
Sunnah al-Nasa, 5,379. I am sorry, you are making fun of your sources and Allah.
I'm making funny of my Allah. I make funny of you because this Google maybe...
That's not Google. Don't touch my phone.
The world is changed. So go find it.
So now Islamic sources are not making sense. I wonder why Muslims are following that. So now listen how Allah's hands are called. Okay? So listen this very carefully. What the angels in his presence of Allah content about, and then he placed his palm between my shoulder and I felt the coldness in my chest. Hands of Allah is cold. He's got two arms and now his hands are cold. And of course, remember? You don't know that? Are you not Sunni Muslim?
No. Muhammad Sunni, but it's
then not why Sunni. Don't you know that?
It's not Sunni.
It's not Sunni.
This is like a new.
Tell me, it is not Sunni.
No, no, this is new.
Tell me, it is not Sunni sources.
Maybe this is different. This
tell
is
me, the 237 tells us hands of Allah, palms of Allah is cold.
No,
are they warm?
No.
It does say that, sir.
This is wrong. This is different.
So Tilmid is lying and wrong. Why do you follow?
This is different.
Tell me about the shin of Allah then, if you
Sharia?
Can't. Shin of Allah. Do you know the shin of Allah?
We don't know everything about Allah.
I'm asking the basics of Allah. I don't. I'm not asking. Give me the knowledge of Allah. Yeah. I'm not asking. Tell me how many believers Allah knows. Yeah. I am asking very basics of Allah. Okay. So can you tell me about the shin of Allah?
There's no shin. Nothing about shin Allah. There's nothing.
Oh, yeah. You said you are Sunni Muslim. Are you sure?
Yeah, but there's nothing about.
Okay. Let me show you. Turn with me. Surah. Surah 68 verse 42.
What is it? I'm not good with numbers. Just tell me the other verse.
Okay. The day that the shin shall be laid bare, and they shall be somewhat prostrate, but they shall not be able to.
I don't know about this, but just I think it's wrong.
So that's verses from Quran, Surah 68, verse 42. It's wrong. Do you read Arabic?
Yes,
I've got Arabic Quran. Arabic Quran as well, if you want it.
Okay.
Do you want Arabic Quran?
Yes.
It's a fucking danger to society.
So we are talking about the cold hands of Allah. Now we are talking about the shins of Allah. Surah 68.
What's the name of the surah?
Yeah, this is Arabic and English for you. Surah 68.
What's Al-Mulk?
Al-Kalam. Kalam. Al-Kalam.
Al-Kalam.
42.
Okay,
go then. Verse 42.
Huh?
Oh, yes, you're right, but I don't know about this really. This is like, not the chin, this is the leg.
Shin.
He means the leg, not the
Yeah, shin.
Okay.
Shin is part of the leg. You know when someone hits you on your shin, it hurts so much?
Oh, sorry, I can't help you with this one really, because I don't know.
So you didn't even, you were even not aware of the verse?
No, this one not really.
Okay,
yeah.
So
really.
This is the verse, okay? Let me read.
But here, the kanji like,
let me tell you what Sahih Bukhari, explain it. Do you follow Sahih Bukhari? Do you follow Sahih Bukhari?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me tell you what the Sahih Bukhari. Okay, tell me the explanation. And I want to know, does Allah, okay, shave his shin? And what kind of thing Allah is going to uncover so people will get to see the shin of Allah?
Well, it doesn't say here, yeah? That Allah will show his chin.
Shin.
It's different.
So chin is this.
No, chin.
Shin. Yeah,
let's
shin.
Let's just say leg. Let's just say leg. Yeah, okay. It doesn't say here that Allah will just show his leg.
It does say. So,
no.
What is that reference? Sahih Bukhari?
Oh, no. That's Jalali.
So you are in Tafsir. I'll tell you the Sahih Bukhari. Okay? In Sahih Bukhari, I heard Prophet is saying, Allah will lay bare his shin. That's what the Quran is saying. Allah is going to open up, uncover his shin.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, you're right. It's absolutely right.
So you are surprised.
But I'm not sure that is a good explanation or not the right one. And the Mayat Allah is at the judgment day.
So on the day of judgment, you are going to recognize Allah from his shin.
Yeah,
so
right.
What does the shin of Allah look like? So yes, you should be able to recognize it.
Yeah, that's when you say something like this, doesn't mean it looks like our chin, our leg.
Yeah, so I have seen shin of men and women, okay? So you've got, for example, lots of female wouldn't have that much hair, males would have hair, some of them are like different, lots of things in the shin. So what is the so special petition of Allah when Allah uncovers his green dress that you will recognize it?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to explain. It doesn't mean like our name. The translation is different from yours.
What is the difference? So like I read it to you. What's your name?
We don't Salim. We don't Salim. Know what it looks like.
Salim, I read it to you.
Yeah.
Allah has two hands, two right hands. Yeah. I read it to you. So just a moment. Can you have a little bit respect to him? Muslims don't even have respect to one another.
The same and say it in the same, but the meaning is different. So that's what it means. You have to know the translate in Arabic is different from English.
He is Muslim and he speaks Arabic and he told us it is the legs, okay, it's
but
the shit.
Really good guy.
It is the shit.
I'm trying to learn.
So, no, you are Arabic speaker, so yeah. You already discredit rest of lots of people. So I already. So, let me make my point first. Can you come a little bit this way?
The meaning here, I think, that day,
Allah on the day of judgment.
Yes, the day of judgment. Everything is gonna be like incredible. It's like no one can realize how scary or big or not dangerous, but really massive things for everyone. And Allah just like points something from his part that's made just like something great. Like when Moses Moses asked Allah just to want to see him, and Allah told him like, if that mountain stays still, you can't see me. Just a little bit, just like he just not a little bit, just like he trying to just to come down, the mountains fall apart. So it just like in that day about the chin or the leg, it just means the day will be really unbelievable. From everyone will be scared, everyone will be like be worried about what they've done, what they're thinking, what's gonna happen.
Yours?
No.
Oh, okay.
So that's what I can't say.
Okay.
More than
so
that,
let me tell you what Islamic sources are teaching. Okay.
Okay.
So on the day of judgment. Sorry, so far I told you about the hands of Allah. Yeah. I told you how hands of Allah is so cold that you felt...
We don't know about this, we don't have this.
I read it to you. I will read it to you again. Let me finish. And then, now we are talking about the shin of Allah, which Allah is going to cover up on the day of resurrection. So, reason for that, according to Hadith, is on the day of judgment, okay, that how true believers are going to be reconciled. How true believers are going to reconcile the true God. On the day of judgment, Allah is deceiving people, okay, and people are gonna recognize him from his shin. Let me read the full Hadith to you, okay, this is Sahih Bukhari. They will bow down, okay? So, Sahih Bukhari, 441, and Sahih Bukhari 993, 532. Those are the hadith references. I read it to you. The Prophet said, Allah will lay bare his shin, his leg, and then all the believers, men and women, will prostrate themselves before him.
Yes.
But they will remain those who used to prostrate in the world for showing off or for gaining good reputation. Such a one will try to prostrate himself, but his backbones will become a single bone, so he will not be able to do so. That's Sahih Bukhari. So it's talking about on the day of judgment, people will see and prostrate, bow down to the shin of Allah. And then Bukhari 993, 532, okay, listen this one. This is not full of it. I just read the part which is relevant, okay? Then the Almighty will...
Give me the number.
Sahih Bukhari.
Yes.
993, 532. 93. Hadith number 532. Do you want me to find you for Arabic?
I better, yeah.
Okay, I'll find you the Arabic one.
That's a good one.
Okay, you found it?
I can't tell, is that right?
So let me read it. Okay. I haven't read the hadith yet, okay? So, then the Almighty will come, then in a shape other than the one which they saw him first. Okay? Then he will say, I am your Lord. And they will say, you are not our Lord. And none will speak to him but the prophets. Then he will be said to them, do you know any signs by which you can recognize him? They will say, the shin. So Allah will then uncover his shin, whereupon the every believer will prostrate before him. So again, there is something in the shin of Allah that people are going to bow down, that people will recognize. So it's probably different than yours. So what is it in the shin of Allah, that physical shin Allah is going to uncover? Because if it is not physical, there is no need to cover it or uncover it, okay? Remember, according to sources, Allah is wearing green dresses. Allah is going to uncover his shin and people are going to recognize that. What does the shin of Allah look like?
Looks like.
I can't tell because we don't have the full description about this, like how Allah's leg, hand, Allah's leg. Even Muhammad, he didn't say, he couldn't see him. You know that Muhammad couldn't see Allah? He just saw the light of it.
Muhammad says, he saw the Allah. Nope. Let me read it to you.
Wait, you've written it. Let me just say something. Yeah. Al-Bukhari, he collected all the hadiths of Muhammad, the false and the right. They ask him, why the false? He said, like, I want to get everything just so people can recognize which right and which wrong. And the one right got evidence on it. The one which wrong, just they kept it just
one of them because they didn't learn this from school. Yeah, let me respond. So, it is very, like, you express yourself as a Sunni Muslim. You took your phone. You express yourself as a Sunni Muslim and you are rejecting Sahih Hadith of, let me finish, Sahih Hadith of Sahih Bukhari.
Yeah.
The reason I have a problem with that, so according to Sahih Bukhari, the book itself, it says everything in Sahih Bukhari, that over 7,000 hadith, yes, they are authentic. Because in the beginning he had 600,000, he got rid of 98% of it, and then he's got nearly 7,000 of it. So everything in Sahih Bukhari is identified as the Sahih. And according to that authentic hadith, Allah has shin, which is going to uncover. It's not only Allah has shin. So Allah has face. Allah has laughter. Allah has two right hands. Allah is deaf. Allah sits on a physical throne and he is heavy. Allah has curly hairs. What else? Allah has a womb.
Nothing like this at all. You know, there's no hair, no face, nothing. We know just like they got this, like hand, like eyes can see, of course, but we don't know what they looks like. How? But he's not like us. Absolutely not, because Allah says he's nothing like me at all. You can never imagine how it would look like. Even Muhammad, when he'd been in Isra and Mi'raj, he just said, I couldn't see Allah, he just saw light. He couldn't can bear that light to look up for longer. But he can't hear him. He listened to him, but yeah, he couldn't see him.
So, Abu Dawud, 4728, that's the hadith number, is going to disagree with you, okay?
Okay.
So, listen this very carefully. I heard Abu Huraira recite this verse. Allah don't command you to render back your trust to those whom they are due. Abdu, for Allah is who hears and sees all things. Okay? That's the verse. And then he said, I saw messenger of Allah putting his thumb on his ear, and his finger on his Allah. Eyes. No, Muhammad is, Muhammad, yes. So as Muhammad is reciting, yeah. Muhammad is putting his hand okay. on his ears yeah. and his finger on his eyes to explain the verse. Okay, so Muhammad is making a case, Allah can hear and he can see all things. Allah is saying, Muhammad is saying, look, Allah has ears like us, physical, okay? And he's got eyes like us, they are physical. Therefore, because Allah has a physical form, like you are fasting on the night of Qadir, night of power. Did you not hope that Allah is coming down to the third heavens to hear your prayer. So Allah even has hearing problems, Allah needs to come down to hear your prayer.
Yeah, it comes just like it's only one time comes, like at night time.
So why Allah needs to come down? Can Allah not see from above the throne? Can Allah not hear?
Allah can do whatever he likes. No, he can't just say why.
That is very dangerous things. Allah can do whatever he wants to do. So Allah is physical. Allah is physical. You've got like, I showed you hadith talking about shin of Allah, hands of Allah. Are you aware that like Allah is not only deaf and he can't see, but also Allah has a womb.
I know, but I can't just say he's like us. Never like that. He didn't, there's no
evidence. But Muhammad says that's Allah wrong. Can hear
maybe
and
that
see.
That's wrong. We didn't learn this about hadith because we know, I'm sure, there's nothing. All my life I've never heard religion and in the school, everywhere. We never heard about such a like this or anything that is like can describe Allah. Nothing. Even no, but Muhammad, nothing.
Salim, where are you from?
Yemen, actually.
Yemen. Please don't take this personal, but no. Is there a chance or possibility that actually people didn't teach you those things? Because no. It is all over the Islamic sources. Like, I'll show you the Islamic sources. Like, listen this carefully. It's all from Islamic sources, okay? So, according to Islamic sources, Allah has body parts. According to Islamic sources, Allah becomes hungry. According to Islamic sources, listen, I will show it to you. According to Islamic sources, Allah becomes hungry and Allah becomes thirsty. According to Islamic sources, Allah has face. Oh. Allah has eyes. He has laughter. He's got hand. He's got two right hands. Let me finish. Allah has the palms, and his palms are cold.
Right, but I can't explain because that's new. But I know the explanation. This is like about the different day. Everyone will be fear and scared, and doesn't really go for all of it. Just because it's a different day. It's like no one, what to do. But now talking about this, Allah's scripture is like...
Allah is physical.
No.
If Allah is not physical, why Allah is coming down to the third heaven? How he is coming down to third heaven? No. If Allah is not physical...
The first heaven.
Just a moment.
First heaven, not first sky. We're looking at the sky, not heaven.
So, how come if Allah is not physical, how come you've got angels who are carrying Allah's throne physically?
Because Allah is like
so physical. Allah is sitting on that throne. He's physical. According to Muhammad, he's got ears and eyes.
This is like saying, why do you exist? Why does that bag exist? Why does that bottle exist?
No, they're not the same thing.
You're questioning existence itself.
No.
Like something that an independent body has formed, you're just questioning it.
So Allah is independent body?
Yes. I'd say that he's above and beyond time and space.
Allah is independent.
That's what makes Allah.
So if Allah is above time and space, why Allah is coming down to hear your people's prayer on the night of power?
That's what he wanted. That's what he said.
On the night of power, night of Qadir, why Allah is coming down to hear your prayers?
Listen, if he
like enters to this world,
he's trying to answer.
Listen,
that's Islam, question to you because you are the one who made the say. Okay, so you don't know he's making the case.
Islam, we don't know everything. We don't know the reason for everything.
I'm not asking you to give me the quantum physics. Very basics of Allah.
No, but just that's what I'm telling you. We don't know everything about Allah. Allah just gave us some a reason for things. Other reason we don't have any explanation for it. Just like example, the pig. We don't know until later. They're like, why the pig is not allowed to eat? At the beginning, they're like, we don't know why. Nobody will know why. Until now, just like they found out why. Example.
So
there's things that we don't know, and we just it's like it's invisible. Just like no reason. Just we have to obey. That's it.
So
why we don't know?
So stop. I'm so.
Allah no, because
would you agree with me?
We can't have all the knowledge. We'll be really crazy.
I do acknowledge that. That we cannot know everything. We are not God. I am not God. I cannot know everything. You are not God. You cannot know everything. Okay?
You learned the Quran once.
No. But I wouldn't have any problem. Uthman did that. So let me say something. Allah has this physical body parts, okay? Allah has hands, okay? And you know, Umar is doing handshake with Allah.
What? What? No.
Listen.
This is new. This is.
I know that because of that I am saying. Salim, because of that I am saying. Do you think there is a possibility that people hide away from you? Islamic sources.
That's really completely different.
Okay.
This is new.
The first person with whom Allah will shake hands on the Day of Judgment will be Umar. First person, Allah is gonna do a handshake with Umar. If Allah doesn't have this physical part, how come Allah is gonna do a handshake? Brother, can we do a handshake? So, look, his hand is physical. His hand is physical.
Do you know what hand, Allah's hands looks like?
I don't know what Allah's hand looks like, but Allah is gonna do. Allah is gonna do a handshake with Umar. Sunnah ibn Majar 104.
This is new, really.
So, can we agree? Can we agree? He's Yemen. He's from Yemen. Is it possible that you did not study, or you were not aware of those very basic teachings on Allah? Is it possible?
Could be, but really, I'm just now really old enough, but I never heard about this.
So, are you
school, college, books from masjid, imam? No one talk about this at all.
But Sunnah Ibn Majah.
This is maybe this is difficult.
Sunnah Ibn Majah is talking about
Sophia.
It. Bukhari is
Sophia. Sophia, they have really good.
Sunnah Ibn Majah is from
who? Ibn Majah.
Yeah, they are hadith number 104. So those are very basic, like your six authentic hadiths. And I'm not like bringing you something which people write today. I can bring it where Muslims are talking what Allah is talking about. Your son took it.
Oh, okay. Ibn Majah. No, that's new. That is really new. I never heard about this really.
What is your problem if those things are true?
I'm pretty sure our rule is not Christ.
Yeah, all the questions are Catholic versus like other ones.
Everyone can see the way people are acting. You want to pretend, you want to act, you want to do.
But are you checking? Do you need help?
Yeah. To check hands.
See, true Asian, yeah, trying to get money where I can. Bro, I don't want to go home and be like, yeah, I got battered in London.
You beat me, right. You beat me with this, yes. Really. I don't know about this hadith.
I'm not beating you. Allah is doing handshake.
But yeah, but shake hands, but not like us.
But how is it?
But just like
but reward, I already but not, no. Like, but it doesn't say rewards. You are Arab speaker. Yeah. It doesn't say rewards, does it? No, it doesn't say that. So I already showed you like Allah has.
So that's right or not being wrong. This is the first time I know this hadith.
That's okay. So would you be? Are you here for holiday or you leaving?
Holiday.
When are you going back?
So.
When are you going back?
Today.
But you are going back today?
I'll have to come again.
Yeah, if you come back, would you be able to check it out?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Because really, for me, this is the first time I know this hadith.
That's okay. People might hide those things from you or you didn't check it. That's okay. We get to learn lots of new things every day. But there is a problem when you say there is nothing like Allah, while Allah has the human stuff. Like he's got shin, he's got womb. He's got hands, he does handshake, his hands are cold, he comes to the third heaven, all those things.
Well, I'll just read that at the end. One of the scholars says here, this hadith is false.
Why? Who is that scholar says that? Because hadith itself doesn't say that.
Yeah, Al-Hafid Imad al-Din.
Who is the scholar?
Al-Hafid Imad al-Din.
Who is he?
A Suyuti. You know Suyuti?
I know Suyuti.
Yeah, he's from the Suyuti. The Suyuti says someone said,
who is that someone? Because Hadith, so
Hafiz Imad al-Din.
So Hadith by itself doesn't say that, okay?
Well,
just a moment. Hadith by itself doesn't say that. Scholars come and then say lots of things. That if you want to take the scholars, that's absolutely fine. But there is a danger of going against your Hadith and picking up the scholars.
You know, when Hadith, when you want to prove Hadith is right or wrong, you have to see the majority of the scholars. If they agree with it, this is right. If they don't agree, it's wrong. So that's what just like about reading
so
to the
would
end.
You not agree with me, Salim? Would you not agree with me? As a Sunni Muslim, one of your best scholars for the humanity is Muhammad, your prophet. After Muhammad, your first caliphs, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, okay?
And then Ali.
So you've got these caliphs. They are your most important scholars, and your scholars...
No, I'm talking about just like the one...
People before that...
They are leaders.
I know, they are caliphs. So, your prophet, best scholar, and then caliphs who lived with the prophet, is telling, this is the those are the things Allah is saying, Allah is passing down. So, I am okay if you are discrediting your hadiths, but that's something you've got to deal with Allah on the Day of Judgment when you discredit. But there is another option.
Yeah.
That it doesn't make sense to you, you will go and check it.
No. Well, that's why I'd love to come next week. I want to check about the chin and...
Shin, hands...
But this one, the last one, I'm sure 100% is false because they didn't agree with it. But I'll check more and just really get more really deep.
But it is there. It is there in 900s, and then someone comes around 1300 disagrees with that.
Who's the 900?
So 400. When is the Ibn Majah's 900s?
Ibn Majah.
Yeah.
900 what?
900s, like, so you've
got... Oh, the age, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, years.
Oh, like, no.
800s, 900s. I can give you the full date
sometimes
if you want.
It doesn't matter the age. Because with Hadith scholars, he's called Albani. He just like 15 years ago, he died, and he was...
Yeah, but like... So you are going to pick up today's scholars versus what people did in that time?
No. We're just saying we can't describe the hadith between false or wrong even now. We can't just...
But don't you see that's a problem? So today, you cannot, as a Muslim, you cannot even be clear that what Muhammad did, what Muhammad said.
Yeah, we can't.
You can't.
Yeah, we can't.
But I'm just giving you the sources, and then you are discrediting them, saying all scholars disagree.
Yeah.
So we don't know.
The sources could be just like.
So we don't know. We don't know what Muhammad did. We don't know what Muhammad said. When Muhammad said that people will see the shin of Allah, when Muslims said Allah is gonna do a handshake, when Muslims are talking about they will see the face of Allah, all those kind of.
People don't want to become Muslim. This is the reason most people are Islamophobes, because these people represent.
I'm giving your Muslim scholars, early Muslim scholars, who took time and compiled those things, and you are disagreeing with them. So, and if you are, and other Muslim scholars in 21st century is disagreeing with them, and that guy is Shia, even Shia and Sunni sources disagreeing with one another, that simply shows me we cannot trust the Islamic sources. Therefore, we will never know actually what Muhammad said and did.
All right, if you want to talk about it, trust in Islamic sources, always.
No, I'm asking the question.
Exactly. Oh, yeah, okay, as example. As a Muslim too, I always take what Muhammad said and his friends.
But I read you what the sayings of Muhammad is. You disagree with that.
I have to see like the rules of it. So it's like, where does it come from? From who? And from who? From who? It could be from like Sufi, Shia, could be from another type. like
Tajani,
different things. We always we have to see if that's come from Muhammad exactly. That would be right.
But you can't know that. You can't know that.
Yeah, we know.
No, yeah, we can't. No, you can't. You can't. So, because those people are his she over there.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a different story.
Just no. He's looking at your sources, and then he says your sources is not trustworthy because of the people. You are looking at their sources, and you are saying their sources is not trustworthy because of the people. So you will never know. Okay. Therefore, I think we should be agreeing and move forward that when it comes to the qualities and physical description of Allah, there are Muslim scholars who talks about he's got like proper human qualities, ears, he's deaf, like, can you imagine? Allah is deaf. Allah needs to come down to the third heavens to hear.
Deaf? No, yeah. not deaf.
Why is Allah coming to the third heavens?
That's his. He's willing. He just like he do whatever he likes.
Allah must be physical for him to do whatever he wants.
I think that is like.
And
like,
whatever he wants in this, he is visiting the third heavens.
The third heaven?
Yeah.
He's not in heaven. He's in the sky. The heaven is different.
Third heaven. No. Like
Christian,
coming down to the
level of the sky. Yes.
Run away!
Oh my God!
Just like you will be raised.
And Allah speaks behind the veil.
Hey, did you? Did